Hey, I'm Hunter and you're watching Linac's Actuator Academy video series for industrial actuators. Today we're going to talk about spindles and how they're important to the efficiency and performance of an electric linear actuator. Now inside of an actuator, there are three main components. You have the spindle, the DC motor, and the gears. They look a lot like this when assembled. A robust and high-quality spindle is essential to optimal actuator performance. When selecting the bars, we need to make sure that we're picking the highest quality materials to ensure that we'll have the highest efficiency for the actuator. The raw material used for Linac spindles is iron bars, which all come with material certificates that prove the properties of the material and prove that they can be used in our applications. The next step in the process is to roll form the spindle threads. We do this by applying 25 tons of pressure to the outside of the spindle to create the strongest possible threads. It's important that at this process we don't produce any flakes on the outside because those flakes can get caught in the spindle grease and they could eventually wear down on the spindle nut. There are many different types of spindles and spindle nuts that can be selected for the actuator's efficiency and load and performance. So, for example, when selecting a spindle nut for a higher load actuator, we try to pick a longer spindle nut that can distribute that load across the threads more evenly. Spindle geometry is also important to the efficiency of the actuator. Trapezoidal, high profile, low profile are all examples of spindle geometry that are used in industrial actuators. When designing spindles with higher spindle pitches, we make sure to add more tracks to the spindle to ensure the same amount of wearing surface as lower spindle pitches. As denoted here, you can see three different colors represent three completely separate tracks that the spindle nut can rotate on. Adding more tracks and increasing that wearing surface makes sure that we have a long lifetime out of the Linac actuator. The core diameter of the spindle, which is the diameter of the spindle, not including the spindle's threads, determines the strength of the actuator itself. The efficiency of the actuator is directly related to the gears, spindle, and the motor, and how they all work together. In a linear actuator, the efficiency is the same regardless of whether you're moving inward or outward, and regardless of the load. However, in hydraulics and pneumatics, the force is different in either direction. For example, when you're moving inward, you have a lower surface area to apply the oil or air's pressure against, and thus you get a lower force on that end. Because of this, when an actuator is pushing a load, it's able to move at the same speed both inwards and outwards. With an actuator's gearing, you can swap out speed for force or force for speed. If you multiply force by the speed, you'll get the power required for the application. This can give you a good idea of what actuator you need to select for your job. So what is spindle pitch? Spindle pitch is the distance that a spindle nut moves along the spindle when it moves 360 degrees around the spindle. For example, we have a 20 millimeter pitch and a 2.5 millimeter pitch down here. As we rotate 360 degrees around the spindle nut moves further on the 20 millimeter than it does on the 2.5 millimeter. The higher the spindle pitch, the more efficient the actuator becomes because there's less surface area between the spindle nut and the spindle itself. However, with a higher spindle pitch, you also have a lower self-locking force. The self-locking ability of an actuator is determined by its ability to resist backdriving when it's not being actuated in any particular direction. Generally, it is said that a spindle with lower efficiency results in a higher self-locking force. For higher spindle pitches where the actuator is not naturally self-locking, typically a brake is used on the actuator. We'll talk a little bit about brakes in a later video in Actuator Academy. The stroke length of a linear actuator is highly dependent on the length of its spindle. For example, Linac actuators can go all the way to 1.2 meters in stroke length. However, when you start to get to these higher stroke lengths, you can run into the risk of buckling, which is why Linac typically reduces the load rating on actuators with higher stroke lengths. The reason for this is that as the spindle nut moves along the spindle, we get a longer rod that has to hold all of that force, and it increases the strain on the actuator itself. For applications where safety is a high priority, a safety nut can be added behind the spindle nut to catch the actuator. If the spindle nut were to somehow wear down and break, The safety nut catches that actuator and allows it to only retract while still holding the load. This is a good indication that it's time to replace the actuator. In comparison to hydraulics and pneumatics, linear actuators can sometimes have a disadvantage when it comes to shock loading, where hydraulics and pneumatics have compressible fluids that can resist that shock. Actuators typically have all of that force directed directly to the motor, and that can sometimes damage it in the long run, especially when you have forces that are greater than the rated load in shock. So those were some facts and tips about spindles and how they relate to the efficiency and performance of actuators. If you have any questions at all about spindles, feel free to reach out to your local LINAC office for more information. Thank you so much for watching.